Kawerau is a one-industry town, so it's really feeling the pressure of the strike and lockout of workers at its toilet paper factory. Another example, firefighters. They've agreed to mediation, a temporary halt to their historic strike action. Those are two situations in a much bigger picture of industrial action. So why now? And does the past hold any lessons? We're joined in the Wellington studio by Victoria University History Professor Jim McAloon. Morena, and thank you so much for being with us this morning.
Kia ora, Jessica. Thanks for having me.
I want to start off by asking you, why are we seeing so much strike action at the moment?
I think it's a combination of things. It's partly a jump in inflation. It's partly relatively low unemployment. I think also it's the stress of the last few years. A lot of workers have had quite a difficult time during COVID and indeed before that. And I think the feeling might be, well, if we don't improve things now, then when do we improve them?
And are you talking there about people like nurses, like firefighters, for example, who have been doing it really tough over COVID, perhaps going above and beyond? Are they the ones that are really crying out for a bit of reward and a bit of recognition?
Well, certainly they're very good examples, and those are occupations too, which are very high stress, physically and emotionally demanding, and where the pay rates are not that great, particularly for fire service workers. And perhaps there's an expectation too that a government that professes to be committed to public services should be delivering for them.
So
but
how
also
much of
workers
it
at Carbondale.
Sorry, you keep going.
Workers at Kawerau too, in the private sector, manufacturing had to step up during COVID as well, and they're a good example, yeah.
How much of it do you think has got to do with the fact that it is a Labor government with a lot of big promises pre-election?
That's part of it, but I think the conjunction of inflation and significant concern about inequality and a long period of relatively low wage increases too are all part of it. I think perhaps the key thing is the relatively low unemployment, and I think that would prompt this sort of examination of things regardless of which government was in power.
And is it the low unemployment plus inflation, and we've got a bit of a perfect storm in terms of our economic situation?
Yes, plus I think the difficulties that a lot of people have had during COVID, and as you said, stepping up, going above and beyond. And I think there's a feeling that it's now time for some payback. And it's not just New Zealand either. We're seeing very similar things in the United Kingdom, for instance.
For New Zealand, though, how does it compare to other times when we've had that intense industrial action? Where does that rate?
I think the last 30 years have been a little bit unusual. We've had the odd spike. 2019 was a spike. There was a bit of a spike around 2012. But from the early 1990s, the Employment Contracts Act really weakened the trade union movement, and there was a very nasty recession during that period as well. I think for unions, there was sort of cautious rebuilding in the first decade of the 20th century. Then came the global financial crisis, and again through the 2010s, unemployment didn't go below 5% for quite a long time. Wage growth wasn't that great. So in terms of the last 30 years, it's a bit unusual. But in the longer term, you have ups and downs. You have spikes and periods of relative calm. I think really, too, what will be interesting will be how things look in another year.
Why do you say that?
Well, just because this is one particular year, and it's hard to say on the basis of one year whether it's a new experience or perhaps something a little bit unusual.
I'm also interested in your thoughts on the generational issue, whether people who are coming through the workforce now have a slightly different attitude to unions and to striking, and what your take is on that.
Well, certainly unions are much less part of the fabric of workplace and society than was the case until the 1980s. That doesn't mean they're absent, and in fact, in the last 20 years, I think we've seen really innovative ways of unions organising, particularly the cross-occupation unions like Unite, like First. We've seen E2 combine a lot of older unions into one. So the union movement certainly hasn't gone away. I think it's rebuilt after the very difficult period of the 1990s. But still, unions are less part of the fabric, I think, for many workers, especially younger ones. In terms of expectations of employment and employers, I think workers have always had a reasonable expectation that their rights will be respected, particularly with reference to health and safety. I think what we have now is a different ways of addressing grievances. It's much more the personal grievance route rather than through the union or that sort of thing. So it's different, but it's also the same.
You mentioned this is a bit of a global phenomena, if you like, with other countries facing this as well. And is that because of the economic global situation?
Well, I think, again, it's a similar sort of set of circumstances as we have in New Zealand. The COVID was a huge shock coming at the end of a period of difficulty. Everybody rallied round then. Essential workers were told how important they were. And perhaps there's a feeling among many workers here, Britain, elsewhere, that, well, if that's to be more than just rhetoric, then a bit of reward would be expected, especially after a decade in which wage growth was low, in which public policies often emphasised austerity, much more in Britain than here, I might say, particularly also as concern about wealth inequality continues to grow with that real inequality becoming observable. So it's all sorts of things, and perhaps it's a generational shift as well. 30 years is a long time. Perhaps it's one of those changes in the fabric which become quite encompassing.
We've certainly been doing a lot of news stories over the last little while on strike action. Thank you very much for your insight this morning. I really appreciate it. That's the Victoria University Professor Jim McAloon.